أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي
We don't have candy, we have dates now. If you tell me why I'm talking to you while you're eating, maybe I can give you this. Anybody tell me why? There's dates. Right on. My eye. There's a lawsuit. I feel a lawsuit coming, inshallah. The reason I'm talking to you while you're eating, because now you know what the pain of hunger is like. Now you know what the pain of thirst is like. And that's the sense of Ramadan, wallahi. Allah's teaching us something. To be able to feel it. Remember when I told you about that, when you hear somebody is hungry, you're not moved as much. But when you see them, you're moved more. But when you actually feel the pain of hunger and thirst, your whole body is actually involved. Now you know what it feels like. Now that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed you with the food and water, ya akhi, how could we leave our sisters on the street? How could we leave our children on the street? The newcomers that lose everybody. So now you know what it feels like, ya akhi. Then he says, هَلْ جَزَاءُ الْإِحْسَانُ مِنْ الْإِحْسَانُ Isn't kindness supposed to be moved with kindness? You know how important is food? You're not even paying attention to me. Most of you are not even listening. You see my mouth moving? Yeah, right, I'm talking to you, right? Because hunger, that's what Allah said, أَطْعَمَهُمْ مِنْ جُوعٍ وَآمَنَهُمْ مِنْ خَوْفٍ Fed them from the pain of hunger and secure them from the pain of the fear. That's what these sisters feel all the time out there on the streets. They're on the streets, don't know what happens. Who's going to come and take them away? What happens to their children? Whether they're going to eat or not. Wallahi, sisters actually go through the garbage bags, by the way, brothers. The sisters go through the garbage bags in order for them to find some food to be able to break their fast on. And here we are, have a second fridge, a second freezer, a second house, a second car. No second wives, but just second whatever it is. But now you have everything that Allah has given you, and we can't leave this place without doing it, wallahi. So take it upon yourself. As I mentioned, I'm not going to push. But what I have heard is the people actually filled very few forms. Okay. So if that person raises their hand, this one will make a special dua for them. We're going to ask for $1,000, which feeds and houses a Muslim sister and her children, inshallah. Who can help us out with $1,000? We'll make a dua for them. For everybody here. Allah is able to give you. Have one. Barakallah. Let's make them 10, inshallah. First sister, may Allah bless you. Take the reward for the rest, inshallah. Who can sponsor the second family, inshallah? Allahu Akbar. Zakallah khair, barakallah. I have the second one to sponsor the second family. Who can sponsor the third family? You get them off the street and feed them, inshallah. Imagine your mother, your daughter, your sister, or your own wife, ya akhi, you're gone. Because you hear that blood, you're gone.
Nobody's looking after them anymore.
We have 2 families sponsored.
We need 10 families sponsored. That's all we're asking for. 10 families sponsored.
We have 2. Who's going to sponsor a 3rd family to get them off the street and feed them, inshallah? Who's going to be the 3rd person? $1,000. By the way, if you don't have to have it right away, you can do it in installments on a monthly basis, inshallah. Who can be the 3rd? Who can be the 3rd? Zakallah khair, ya akhi. 3rd family is off the street and fed,
$200 for the brother. I'm looking for $250. You can help us out with $250. $250. I got $200. I'm looking for $250. You can help us out. Beautiful ring with a beautiful cause. And it's coming back, by the way, this money's coming back, actually. The beauty of it, you get something in this dunya, you get something in the hereafter, and you save a sister. Allahu Akbar. What a better cause. In the month of Ramadan, last 10 days, an odd evening, mashallah, multiples of reward. I have $200. Last call, who can help us out with $250 for a ring? A beautiful ring coming back for a good cause. All right, last one is $200. I'm looking for $250. So, $200 going once, $200 going twice. Sold for the brother for $200. Zakallah khair. Barakallah fiqh. Okay, here we go. Now, sisters, you can take out any gold we accept. We take American Express, MasterCard, Visa, anything. American dollars, pesos, rupees, you name it. Anything, inshallah. Zakallah khair. Again, don't forget the donation boxes. Don't forget to fill out the forms. Zakallah khair. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Barakallah fiqh. Subhanakallah Muhammad. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
JazakAllah khair for helping us, Sheikh Ala. For those of you who do not know, Sheikh Ala is a director at Mercy Mission. He is the director of public relations, mashallah. And he just returned last night from Calgary and now is doing this. Alhamdulillah, he's working hard, spreading the word about the Medina, because inshallah, it is going to impact the lives.
This Friday, iftar is cancelled, but everything else, inshallah, is on. Speaking of iftar, we are, mashallah, zakum la khairan for your support. However, we're a little behind on supporting the iftar for the 3 days instead of one. So we're asking you to help us out to keep this iftar going so we can support the brother. Well, like I saw one brother today that said, you know, I was driving by and I saw the masjid and he came in for iftar. Alhamdulillah. So let us have that spirit, inshallah, to be able to do it. So support us on the way out for the program of iftar, inshallah. Last is that something. There was something. I was sure there was 3. Qiyam, yes, thank you, Sheikh. Qiyam, inshallah, tahajjud will be starting at 3 o'clock tonight. 3 o'clock, inshallah. So come and join us. Barakallahu feekum. And the last thing I leave you with, and you know, we know that we're in the 10, last 10 now. Let's have a game plan. What's the game plan? There's something in your home you need to turn off. I'll give you one guess what that is. What is it? Your TV set, mashallah, it's in stereo. Everybody says it. You know it. We know that. It's a behavioral issue, right? It's a thief. Wallahi, we was watching, and I said, usually, you know what, man, I don't want to. Because you know you feel when you don't watch the stuff, your iman increases a bit, your heart is a little stronger, your battery is charged, your eyes has the automatic shut-off valve, right? When you see sisters in humanity, right? Walking by, you automatically have the shut-off valve. So now, the yadusuna sumu fil asad, right? So they add some poison in the honey. You see things that are good, all that stuff, and all of a sudden you see another girl, Allah help us, wallahi. SubhanAllah, ya akhi, you're watching even some of the stuff, you're watching some of the religious issues, right? Some of it, and all of a sudden you see a commercial, you know, hishtik bishtik and all that stuff, Allah musta'an, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, you know. So now we're asking you for one thing. If you know for sure, and controlled stuff, only religious stuff, you know, Quran and Tafsir and all of them, like Mecca and Medina, they have, alhamdulillah, now 2 channels that are awesome. One, it gives you the haram, right? And it gives you Quran all the time. And the other channel gives you the Medina Munawwara, the haram of al-Madani, not the Mecki, and it gives you a hadith all the time. Stick to that, or do something. Or whatever it is you have to do, just stick to that, please. Last,
Well, a few inshallah. So, last 10, we know Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to do what? He used to do his best in the last 10 days. So, you should have, wallahu alam, finished one Quran by the 10. Now you do your best now in another 10. But this time you add a twist. You need a tafsir. You need to understand what this Quran is about. Right? Remember? So, when you do this, when you read the Quran and you have the tafsir, remember the notebook? We have to go back to that notebook, Yaqi. Notebook that you split in half, remember? First half is what? Awamir. Did I not talk about this Hebrew word? I can't remember what I had for breakfast, man. Come on, dude. So last thing, what is it? Homework. Awamir. The notebook that you will buy, inshallah, tonight. The first half is what? Awamir. Commands of Allah. When you read the Quran, you pass on a command, you write it down. Allah said, do this. The second half of the notebook, what do you do? Nawahi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbid us to do this. You're going to write that on the left-hand side. And what do? You keep reminding yourself now. These are the commands. These are the nawahi. Remember, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu says, on judgment day, every verse of the Quran will come and ask you a question. تأتي بالآمرة هل اتمرت وتأتي بالنهي هل انتهيت. The verse that commands you to do something will come and say, Allah commanded you to do this. Did you do that? And the other verse that forbids you to do something will come and say, Allah forbid you to do this. Did you stay away from that? So why don't you do your homework, Yaqi? Write it down. Awamir, Nawahi. Commands, prohibitions. And check it out. If not on a weekly basis, at least on whatever it may take, inshallah. So homework quickly, inshallah. Turn off your TV or turn it around or watch stuff that is very controlled. Because once you see something, it affects you whether you like it or not. This fitna woman, Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says, this is what I fear for you, brothers and sisters. So increase your iman in the last 10. Come to the masajid. Come to the tahajjud. Let's see most of you in the tahajjud, inshallah. It's a weekend at least. Let us increase. Listen, make dua. Come. Istighfar, tasbih, dhikr all the time. It's like your golden opportunity. Last 10 days. Remember the guest we talked about? The guest in the beginning of the month? Guess what? The guest is saying so long. You may not see this guest again ever in your life. So take care of that guest. Take advantage of it. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the last 10 days the best 10 days, inshallah. Allahumma balighna layla al-qadr. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us live till the night of power, inshallah. And the time? 3 o'clock. Okay. So just in case. 3 o'clock tonight, inshallah. I love you, man. Okay, we'll see you tonight, inshallah. Zakatul Fitr is $7 to $10, depending on how rich you are, or like this poor slave of Allah. May Allah help you, inshallah.
الذي جعل لكم الأرض مهدا وجعل لكم فيها